Hi there, my name's Rich. I'm Senior PPC Manager here at Jellyfish. So, how much are you paying for your brand terms? I'd be willing to bet it's not very much, especially compared to what you're paying for your generic terms. And you're probably getting really good returns from it as well, which means there's an opportunity. Any small improvements we can make for our brand campaign can have a positive overall effect on your overall campaign as a whole. What I want to share with you today is a brand test we did for one of our clients that really helped improve that campaign in the face of stiff competition. So there are going to be occasions when competitors will try and worm their way into your brand space, just try and aggressively show an ad below you a lot of the time. They might be doing this because they might have an aggressive offer, which gets them a reasonable click-through rate and hence a reasonable quality score, but most likely they're going to need to bid quite aggressively to get there. So to be able to combat this a little bit, what we need to do is just understand how the actual ad auction works. So it's what's called your ad rank that dictates your position on the SERP. And that is simply calculated by multiplying your max CPC bid by whatever Google dictates your quality score to be for that particular auction, for that particular search. Then how your actual CPC is calculated is simply the ad rank of the person in the position below you divided by your quality score. The way the math of that works out is that you'll always pay equal to or slightly below your max CPC bid for that click. So let's plot a scenario now where we were seeing some high CPCs for one of our clients' brand terms. We've got a really high quality score because we get a high click-through rate because it's our brand, and so we don't need to bid a huge amount to be able to get a really large ad rank. The person in the position below us though, that aggressive competitor, might get a reasonable quality score but still nothing like what we're getting, but then we'll have to bid aggressively to get there, and they must be doing if we're getting our high CPCs. The person in position 3 though, they might not have a high quality score or a particularly high bid. They're just getting a high enough ad rank to get into the auction to get shown by Google. So let's look at that. Actually, it's the position below us that dictates our CPC, which means that actually, because the competitor in position 2 has a really high ad rank, we actually end up paying quite a lot. But then it's not necessarily the case that they're paying a particularly large amount, because the competitor in position 3 hasn't got a particularly high ad rank at all. So what we've got is a scenario where there's an aggressive competitor in position 2 who's probably getting not a huge amount of clicks, but some, and when they are getting them, not paying very much for them, but then they're inflating our cost per click for all the clicks that we're getting. All seems to be a little bit unfair. So how can we counter this? Well, ask the question, do we really need to be in position 1, even for our brand terms? Okay, there are brand benefits there of being in position 1, but actually if we can drop our bids, get to a lower position, then we might actually make some really big cost savings. And the dropping click-through rate might be negligible. So that's what we did. We plotted the scenario, we had some educated guesses based on what we thought the competitors' bids were and their quality score, and therefore what their ad ranks might be, and then dropped our bid accordingly to appear consistently in position 2. So what this means now, if we look at the scenario, is that we've now got much lower ad rank, we're in position 2, but now the ad rank that's dictating our CPCs is that much lower one in position 3. Then the aggressive competitor moved up to position 1, which isn't ideal, but now it's our monster quality score, which is meaning our high ad rank is pushing their CPCs up to well above what they're paying. And the results we saw were amazing. Okay, we saw a bit of a drop in click-through rate from 21% down to 17%, so that represents about an 8% or so drop in clicks. But we saw a 75% drop in our cost per click. Also, we didn't even see a huge amount of sales drop because of it, about 4%. We suspect this is because all the people that represented the 4-point drop in the click-through rate just went to the organic link and clicked there, so we saw slight rise in the number of SEO conversions we had, but then a lot of more existing users were put onto the organic link, and hence it was the new users, the ones who were more ready to buy, that clicked on the PPC link. So actually, it served to qualify the ad, and our conversion rate actually rose. So I'd say we feel a little bit sorry for the competitor who saw their CPCs quadruple for a term they were doing quite well on before, and they fell off the landscape a week or so later, but I can't say we feel too sorry for them. So what can we learn from this? Well, firstly, you don't necessarily need to fall in love with position 1. Make sure you're not just vanity bidding for the sake of it without any data to back up your decision. Secondly, a better understanding of the ad rank auction can give you more insights, can reveal things to test, and help make really good improvements to your brand campaign or your campaign as a whole. Thanks a lot.